coming back. To the game between Duncan Dixon and one of the young players. Duncan playing red and yellow ball. That is hoop number six. Play for hoop number six. And Duncan is leading 4-1. Corner there, on the starting corner, are getting ready to play Josh Freer against Logan. On second colors. Position as the red ball is a bit hampered. And he is using one of his jump shots techniques around the hoop. Very accuracy and delicateness. Duncan scored the two. scoring from the band with yellow. Left corner, just starting the game. Logan and Josh. Logan plays the green ball. Josh follows with the pink. Josh is going to clean green ball. So he does, but unlucky. Green ball hits the hill and stays on the front. Looked like it's in good scoring position. A bit angled, but see what Logan will be able to do. Yeah, it's in good scoring position. You are handsome. Why do you hide from the camera? Yours.
He's another, what is his last name?
Matt Hockendale.
He's another player, young player with that last name? A tall one?
No, I don't think so.
He played in Nelson Nationals in New York. Who came with his mother?
No. Same person? So he wasn't.
No.
He wasn't.
No, he has changed much. It's the same name, look for me. I'm not good with the names. But look for seeing the name.
Probably the same person. Yeah, it's going for a bit of a growth spurt.
Just looking. In the world, they are plenty in he played a social game against Red?
Lachlan.
Yeah, but it's not now I am sure that he's not the same person.
No.
He now must be a bit older than him because I was told that he's just 18.
It's not like that, you think about
Lockie. Lockie, yeah.
Lockie doesn't play anymore, I've been seeing him in
the
time.
Yeah.
The same thing with, there's another kid I think played Bridge as well. Henry Mills, he
For Boris Wood.
Yeah.
Nada, he doesn't play anymore.
Lucky Hughes is the
class. Lucky Hughes. How is going your vegetarian diet? Still keeping vegetarian?
Yeah. Easy thing.
Yeah, I like meat and fish. But before I came back from Europe, in the last week or 10 days, as I used to buy meat on a certain large quantity, and I didn't have any, I decided to not buy in those week or 10 days. Mm-hmm. I became vegetarian. But not like you, that don't take neither butter or... Do you take milk?
No
milk, so...
Talk about knowledge.
You are very, very fanatic vegetarian, complete or fully, or how can I name you? And I was thinking of you while I did cook a couple of times meals for 2 or 3 days. And so in that length of time, I was vegetarian. And I was enjoying so much the taste without any meat, but the vegetarian, vegetable oil. So nothing, no milk, no butter, no cheese, no. And those meals was beautiful taste. And I said, maybe Duncan. There's not wrong.
I tried making a vegetarian lasagna, and I was using that fake stuff that you get from the supermarket.
Yeah,
it turned out alright. I'm still trying to work on that. It's like, because you got to try and find a vegetarian cheese that you like to go with that, and it's, I can't know, I don't like the vegetarian cheese. Yeah. I'm still trying to work on that.
But those vegetarian... burgers we have in Egypt, you remember?
Yeah.
They were with beans.
Yeah.
Yeah. They were so tasty. I couldn't believe that they didn't have meat. So tasty. So rich in taste and energy.
Like, by me around, they're like, eat. And I'm just like, yeah. were you there when the guys invited us around?
Yeah. I remember that they were in that corner of the court.
Yeah.
And they offered me the meat.
Yeah.
And I enjoyed them. You were in the other corner there. And I asked them, and they said, no, they are vegetarian. Okay, I will ask the guy who is completely vegetarian. I said. So I went to remember from their coming. Yeah, you got good food there.
Obviously,
yeah, but nice guys, because in Egypt, you know, like in India,
yeah.
I think the not as pronounced as in India, but in Egypt as well, most of the players in the crop play are from highly educated and rich families. They didn't have any respect for the who played second in Australia last year, played the final. I think you played him as well, with this thing. Ahmed.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Not Al-Mahdi, the other one. Not Al-Mahdi, the other one.
I think this one.
I think you played him, you beat him
recently. Yeah.
But
I
he used to be, they said, he used to be a ball boy and from a poor family. In his youth, not so good people, maybe. So they didn't have any respect for him. Despite that he was a very good player, they didn't have any respect for him. So the people who were cooking that meal, that was a very good meal, were all educated people. Then they were surprised by my name and told the museum. Mm-hmm. And they asked me where I was from. And I told them, I am the blood of your king, etc. Because the king, the three generations of king they had, from the time they became independent from the Ottoman Empire, was an Albanian from the south of Albania, which nowadays is Greece, that Mehmed Ali Pasha, who became king of Egypt. And for three generations, his son and his grandson ruled Egypt. And they had a high respect. And one of the ladies who played the role of many rich Egyptian women wanted to have kids with the king because he was handsome and clever and very good high. And he immediately, when I said I am glad of your king, he immediately, I'm Albanian, he knew. And most of the Egyptians don't know the origin of their king. But the people who have studied and have a certain education, they know. So that meal cooked there was a really good taste and well cooked, and people, very nice people, very friendly. Mm-hmm. When I came back from Egypt, I was with Chris Clark and Mike Fashion waiting to catch the flight. Mm-hmm. And then Chris left in another flight. It was me and Mike coming with the same flight to New Zealand. And we had in Doha somewhere, we stopped and we shared a cup of coffee. And we were talking about the hospitality of the Egyptians, because they gave us a free lunch every day. Yeah. You know? And Thursday, I couldn't eat all of it. I threw it away, but came the dinner time. I played till after 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
And I became hungry. So next day, I started to save the rest of the lunch.
Mm-hmm.
And then two parties, you remember? Two big parties they organized. And I said, are we going to do the same thing for them? No, he said. Just a free cup of coffee, maybe, with a box in the side. Donation accepted.
Duncan, can I get you to stand back up? Cheers.
You're tempting.
think I screw him around. Did you do that? Need to do that, let me have. was a good outcome of that mistake. I have seen in the World Cup that the guys who did the mistake benefited.
Yeah.
So sometimes it's not the right rules.
Giving signals over there.
He maybe didn't agree with your decision, then.
I
think that was good because in the world, when they
had you seen them,
similar, and benefited the guy who made the mistake.
What was going to say? Had you noticed they were playing out of turn or what? You hadn't picked it up, you weren't bored.
How did it start? No.
I didn't follow. It's nothing to do with that.
I didn't follow. Who did do the mistake and how long ago did start the mistake? I didn't. Only when Josh scored.
Mm. And we saw him, but also Duncan was walking over to me.
How long they have been out of order?
I just wondered if you'd noticed, but what I was going to say is, as a spectator, if you notice,
I can help.
You call straight away. Yeah. No, not help me, you call straight away. Call out to them, white ball to play or green ball to play. As a spectator, you can do that.
I can do that.
Yes.
They have kept mistakes, right?
So that's what I was saying. Had you seen that they were out of turn, you could say stop, and then just say it's a green ball to play.
Yeah.
Especially when you see they're going to play the wrong ball. When I walked over to them, I couldn't even think who was playing, the pink and white, and who was pink. And yet I'd be watching them, and that's just changing from spectator to referee. It's really interesting. A player to referee is even worse. If you're in the middle of the game and they ask you to make a decision, it's all.
Like I know you're watching the referee. The first time you've seen it. You've seen it before.
Mm.
But looks much more than
he does.
So body.
What's his name? Logan.
Logan, the Michael Cordero.
Oh, there is that Michael Cordero.
Yeah. And I was surprised that the partner of Chris was there. But Josh did that. And he won the first game. He's a 0 in his position. It was not a result that I want to see him play.
I've never seen him play once. I couldn't watch him as much as I can. I haven't seen England play all day. I'd love to watch it.
Now, 2 years. Perfect.
What a shot. What a shot.
And they master that swing. They are so accurate.
When they're accurate, they're very accurate.
But
when they're not accurate, they're not accurate.
They're
I would love to do a statistical survey. I just wanted, you know, a whole world of whacking and not whacking. Which was the one
casting, what is called that?
Yes.
Casting? A lot of like
more than George Smith? Yeah.
And in the end, he took it. What happened? In more than two matches, that I had the chance to watch her.
Yes, yes.
I was. She won the first game.
Yeah.
She lost by 76, 75, 76 in the second game. Then lost by far the third game. And one day, staying like that, none of us was there.
Yeah.
In the second game, you are going so so. But the third game, you're
done.
We were in the beginning, not different groups, but I didn't qualify for the top.
Oh, yeah. And then you play the same foot. I scored the first one. She scored 6. Mm-hmm. 2-0. Played 6-2.
Yeah.
And when she was up 3-4, yeah. 4-2. 4-2. She won the ball and hit my ball and hit me 6.
Mm-hmm.
And the people was with her. It was a man.
Yes, it is. And it was in Egypt, yeah? Mm-hmm. Even in Egypt, mm-hmm. Okay. Even in Egypt, yes.
And then change the game, but I can't watch people. It's like
this.
Because it's like your team, when your team do this, you have to do it at once.
Totally.
Nobody can interfere.
Yes.
Only if previous ball is very near,
yes,
can
it
happen.
Can.
as he got back in. Just in a way, it's very cool, one of them. Yeah.
I think it's less important than more because when it's less important than the show,
don't fight.
Huh?
Don't fight for the trip.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they keep holding us up all the time.
Mm-hmm. Which have you not time, Dad?
She went for me too.
Oh, I know he did. I mean, I understand why he did it, but
yeah,
I just don't know.
Yesterday, the wrong things. Tell the ankle to repair. He went through. Missed the middle one. But I thought he never did that. That was just in the right spot. To hit hard, not even that. Not even that. Why so hard?
It's the inner point of
everybody does sometimes. I feel bad when I do it. But I feel so comfy now that everybody does it.
Oh, no. Yes, she's joined the gang. none of you could get knocked off there.
How many matches per day do you have?
Just three.
Three matches per day.
Okay, well, nine games.
Yeah. Would last three days, 9 or 3 days. This number the order of play that we will make the top three will meet each other on the third day. Top three on the block.
I'm not sure, I mean I'm playing these numbers today, I think.
I think everybody plays everybody, and then it's a top.
I don't know, they've done their seedings a bit, like the whole WCF seedings and all out of all the year now.
They've done it on WCF seedings?
There's some sort of reason for it that Stephen Mullen has come up with, but you know, everything that Stephen Mullen does is weird.
It's not so much the initial seeding, is it? It's what happens after.
Everything's done correctly in the book. It's just, that's just the book is done.
I think it works for most things.
I mean, because I don't see how first seed plays second seed on the first day.
Yeah.
It's just not really weird.
What did you say first played second on the first day?
So I played Edmund as well.
That is different.
You play Edmund today.
And your Christian Nelson, tell him to get his. No, I mean, we've just had a tournament management get together seminar about 2 or 3 minutes ago.
Sharp.
And we've got the hang of it. And it certainly wasn't that. And you keep playing everybody and not playing in blocks. It's a very easy one to see.
Sometimes it works better because you know where you stand and how the others are going. So
what do you mean? If you see the point of your back,
you got me to put all the effort in one game.
Mm.
Well done.
You hit that peak, Josh, it should be able to get
anywhere. Remember where it came out?
It hit the white peak.
Yeah, easy to remember.
It's still feeling of rain, isn't it?
Yeah, it was forecast some showers.
Well, I don't know whether it's a forecast, because you never know. I mean, you can't change it, even if you find it's going to rain. There's nothing you can do about it. I'm just taking a raincoat.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now they are very active, I think. In old days, it was a job, not a nice job.
Yeah. When they are forecasting a sunny day,
yes,
they can really say it's going to rain. When they are saying it's going to rain, you just forget about
it. What's that here, you mean? Here, anyway.
No, no. Yeah. But in old days, in most of the countries in Italy, all over, the post not always free.
Of course it doesn't. Where is it?
This is the peak of summer of six meters of the two waters are apart from each other.
In one place, is only one kilometer.
That was a hard ball.
Did they stop? For the wind maybe, or he wants to cast from...
Who's to play? What are we waiting for?
Why? Shots.
see?
I think it was
this
side, yeah. Was he. Looks like now the scores are 6-4 for Logan. Playing for hoop number 11.
green.
As you saw, Logan scored the hoop number 12 and winning the first game between them. Best of three match. And now they are going maybe for a lunch break and playing the second game next. Duncan Dixon, leading 6-4, and now 6-5. Duncan now is the first, with hit number 12, with his red ball.